The last video was quite short. This one is going to be a little longer because it's a little bit more intense, a little bit more diverse, and it's a little bit more special because this brings me into the world of out-of-body experiences. What's strange is that in this period, which was still December 2015, I was busy with lucid dreaming, but I still had no real understanding of even giving any attention to the out-of-body experience. I was just so full of just lucid dreaming. But I did notice through that period that there seemed to be a change in my consciousness happening, in my dreaming consciousness. That I was becoming more aware, very, very subtly, even in my normal dreams, where they were becoming more, they were having more depth to them. And it was as if I was being led through my dreams towards where I would eventually go, which was practicing out-of-body experiencing. And I say that because this dream actually had me learning out-of-body experiences from the dream state. So I'll tell you what happened. I'd slept in the night and woken up around 4 o'clock in the morning, and I do not remember any dreams I had in that night, which is really strange for me because I usually dream very, very actively in that first 1.5 hours after falling asleep. And this time I didn't. I slept all the way through till 4 o'clock. And I don't remember anything of the dream. But I went back to sleep. And what happened then was I fell into a dream right away. And I was in a class as part of a group of people who were studying under an instructor how to have out-of-body projections. And while I was sat there, there was one woman who was having some sort of private tuition, private guidance by the teacher, who was also a woman. And I would have been in line to actually talk to her next. So I just sat back and just watched what she was saying to this girl. And there was some kind of induction process first. But I can't remember what that induction process was. I just remember the technique that she was telling this other woman, this pupil of hers. It had something to do with imagining the destination you want to go to, visualizing it, and then imagining a line or a cord from you to that destination. While I'm watching her, this woman get her lesson, I was following along as if I was being inducted. I went through the induction in my own mind, and then I started to imagine this line to some location I wanted to visit. And I had in mind London or Paris, because at this time I'm living in Amsterdam. And I pictured London or Paris, I can't remember which one first now. I think it was Paris. I pictured this location, and I pictured this line joining me, my body, to that location. And it worked immediately. I found myself standing in a street somewhere in modern day Paris. I thought, it's worked. I've just had an out-of-body experience. So I tried it again to another place. And I picked London then this time. And I imagined London, imagined the line from me in Paris to London, and there I am. I'm standing in a street in London, totally different from the Paris streets. And I recognize it as London because I used to live there. I knew what it was like. So there I am in London. I thought, this is great, I'm going to try somewhere else now. What happened next was I imagined, I think it was Paris again, and I ended up in Paris, but this time in a completely different time. I think it was, I had a feeling it was around the 1800s. There were people walking the streets with different clothes, right? Old clothes from the 1800s style. And there were no cars or anything on the streets. The streets were cobbled, and it was a very cold winter's type day, a little grey. And there was a horse and carriage that came trotting past. And I saw these two old people on the pavement. And I walked up to them and I asked them to tell me where I was and what the date was, and they just ignored me or looked at me first strangely and didn't really want to talk to me and turned away. So I thought, well, I'll try and get back to London then. And then the whole dream changed. For some reason or other, I had this thought in my head of my father. My father's an old man and he lives alone in England. And I was a little concerned that everything was okay with him. I hadn't heard from him for a few weeks. And because I thought of that, I was transported to his place and his house, and I could see him looking okay, doing his thing, and I was comforted by that. So I was able to let go of him and go back to London again. Again, with this technique of imagining the place and having this line to go to it. And I turned up in another city, but it looked like the outskirts of a city this time, not the centre of a city. And I thought, where am I now? This does not look like London. So I went wandering around a little bit and I noticed the street signs, and they were in Dutch. And as sometimes happens in dreams, even though you've never been to a place before, you have the feeling that you know where you are and you can direct yourself from that place to wherever you want to go, the house, wherever it is. So, and I had that feeling then that I recognized where I was in relation to where I lived in Amsterdam. So I presumed, because the street signs were Dutch, that I was in Amsterdam. And I knew how to get to my home. But I didn't go there. I was considering carrying on this practice of transporting myself to different countries. And to take a pause, I just sat down outside this corner shop on the steps to get my bearings, try to think, well, where am I exactly in relation to my house in Amsterdam, because I didn't recognize the street, and to plan where I wanted to go next. And that's the moment I woke up out of this experience. Immediately went out my bed, got out my bed, and wrote this up because I didn't want to forget this one. So, yeah, this was my first out-of-body experience, I could say. It wasn't the first self-induced out-of-a-waking state out-of-body experience, but definitely my first experience that is different from the lucid dream experience. Projecting to a different place. I know you can do this within lucid dreams, but then you come into the argument of what is the difference between a lucid dream and out-of-body experience, and I don't want to go there in this video because I don't believe there is a difference. But this was a definite progression of my practice, a definite progression of my awareness within the dream state. Because I didn't have that lucid dream feeling while I was dreaming, while I was taking this class, there was no thought of, I'm dreaming and I'm taking a lucid, an out-of-body class. This is going to work. I was in a normal dream that I presume was reality and took the class and then had my out-of-body experience from there. This is really screwed up stuff if you think about it. You don't know where you are, you don't know where you're going. But it took me to, even though I've not had any conscious interest in the out-of-body experience to this point, it certainly took me there and I wanted to know a little bit more about it. And it happened again a few days later. And I'll tell you about that in the next video. That was even stranger than this one. So if you've had any similar experiences where you've learned techniques from a guide or a class or a teacher or whatever and put them into practice in your dreams to actually induce greater experiences, lucidity or out-of-body experiences from the dream state, let me know, because it's a really fascinating topic to talk about and to discuss, and I'm sure lots of you out there have had those sort of experiences. For me it was special, for me it was very enlightening and great fun, of course, always great fun. So I'll leave it there for now, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.